Congress has just 3 weeks left to decide the fate of President Obama's controversial nuclear deal with Iran. After weeks of intense lobbying, the White House appears closer to getting the plan past Congress, despite polls that show a majority of Americans are against it. And now nearly 200 former military leaders have come out against the agreement as well. George Thomas has that story.
With Congress set to vote on Iran's nuclear deal next month,
the Iran nuclear deal. Good deal or bad deal?
Both sides are making last-minute pitches for and against the agreement.
The latest, nearly 200 retired U.S. generals and admirals from every branch of service have written to Congress, urging lawmakers to reject the deal.
The letter warns that the agreement will enable Iran to become far more dangerous, render the Mideast still more unstable, and introduce new threats to American interests as well as our allies. One of those key allies, Israel, got a warning from a senior Iranian official this week. Hussein Sheikh Aslam, a foreign affairs advisor, said he rejects the existence of any Israeli on this earth and added, "Our positions against the usurper Zionist regime have not changed at all. Israel should be annihilated, and this is our ultimate slogan." The Iran deal is meant to prevent the Islamic regime from building a nuclear weapon, but critics say it's not going to work. Despite serious opposition to the deal, it appears President Obama is closer to getting the votes needed to pass it through Congress. So far, 29 Senate Democrats have backed the deal. 2 are against it. 15 are still undecided. Supporters need 34 votes to uphold a presidential veto. A key Republican admits the president's aggressive campaign is paying off. "I don't think there's any question, but the lobbying effort by the administration certainly has generated results," Bob Cork of Tennessee told the Associated Press. But while supporters feel momentum on Capitol Hill, most Americans are against the nuclear agreement. Voters in the swing states of Ohio, Pennsylvania, and Florida fear the deal will make the world less safe. George Thomas, CBN News.